My mistress used to say, you know, that horses were trained. They just teach us the way they like to be ridden. You can train a horse out of fear, any animal actually, out of anything you want. You can train him with love, you can train him with fear, you can train him with all the nuances between those, and you can train them by pain. You can train them all sorts of ways. If you have a good relation with your horse, everything is going to be easy.
This is Fadista, and this is a very young horse. He's 4 years old, and he's one of the son of Pasquale, Don Pasquale, my Portuguese stallion. And we are going to show how a young horse is to be longed. Something that you have to be careful at the beginning with a young horse, they could be afraid by the longe line, or they could be afraid by the whip. Therefore, what you should do is, and it's not going to really work with that young horse because he has been done before, but you have to go through the wall and then have the horse against the wall right here, for example, and you pat him and say that everything is fine, and then very gently touch them with the whip here and tell them that everything is fine and they have to respect the whip and not to be afraid of the whip. They would respect it but not be scared. It's a very, very important point. A lot of horses get scared and then they can't function. You have to tell them you will never use the whip against them, but always for them and with them. For when that is established, now you are going to have him going on a circle around you. And some of the young horses have a tendency to kick and have a little bucking thinking. And you have to be very careful to differentiate the bucking, which is basically happiness and little jump of happiness that they do, with the bucking that really reflect a soreness or even a pain in their back. Therefore, If it's happening with a violent bucking, you have to look into something different with their back. And the work in hand often is going to determine this. You want a forward trot. You have a visualization in your head, a little click with the tongue, and a little touch with the whip if you need to. There we go. And then we are going to have a transition down. And generally for the transition down, I like to use a whistle. You whistle and you will see the horse will slow down. That's a boy. And you want to walk. That's the boy. There. Walk on. Very calm, very quiet. If the horse wants to go close to you at one point or another when they are young, no big deal. What you need is to be very calm and quiet and knowing what you want. You want the horse to slow down. You ask him with a little whistle. If it's not enough, you shorten your longe line and you get a smaller circle and they would walk. Good boy. There, when they walk, you let the circle get longer, get larger again. They go into a trot. You just shorten your longe line. That's it. We're back into a walk now, very calm and quiet. For a lot of horses, walking is a little difficult at the beginning. They would rather run. They would rather trot or canter. Therefore, it's a good discipline to be able to have them walking and with you. Now, let's see a little bit about his head position now. You can see he can put his nose up in the air, a little up, a little down, whatever he wants to do. When he's down, he's better, but then he wants to throw his head up, and that's not what we want. Well, that's why we are going to use one side reins to allow him to stay in the correct position. Want to walk again, a little whistle. Good boy. And once again, we are going to determine which lengths of the rein, of the saddle reins, we need. 4. Of course, it depends on the length of the neck of the horse and also where the head is attached to the neck. In other words, a horse with a shorter neck is going to need a shorter side reins and a lower side reins. But we will see here what it is. And you know, you try. If it doesn't go correctly, well, you go and do it again. You shorten it again. The name of the game is to try to have your horse, the side rein as long as you can, and the horse be on the bit, walk, trot, and canter. That's it. Sometime, even a too long side rein will do the job. Therefore, don't worry about it. As long as the horse stay around, that's what you want to do. Exactly. Very good there. Very good. Now you can see the back of the horse, the back leg of the horse going in the print of the front leg. And that's what you are looking for as a minimum trot, is the back leg going in the print of the front leg. And you are going to see there's a lot of good rhythm for that young horse here. Lots of good rhythm. For you are looking for relaxation in the round position for the young horse. That's it. Very good there. See, I can imagine myself sitting on my horse with the same kind of head carriage and be very happy about that trot. It's a nice forward trot where the horse is using himself. And as you see, he's trying to find a position for his head. It goes up and down, and there's a little variation of rhythm. Hola. That's it. Go back to a trot. And if they go into canter, this is no big deal. They are trying to find a position in which they are comfortable. Therefore, you let them figure it out. You see the horse who is lightly chewing on his bit and starting to be happy about that position. Good. Very nice there. Very nice. The advantage and the disadvantage of using one side rein is, of course, it gives the horse a chance to put his nose down if he wants to, or to twist his neck and go up. Therefore, that's a little bit more demanding of the person who launched the horse to make sure the horse is forward and round. But then when the horse decides to be in that position, he knows exactly what is that position that he is into. Good. He's a lot more conscious about it. Very nice there. Very nice. Ah. And we are going to go back into a walk. Ah. Very good. Walk on. That's it. Very good. All right. Well, that would be what we will be looking for a young horse as far as his launching.